of a lot of money out of it.
Heck, he did.
And like I said, in order to sell my game, I'm going to establish a company and call it by meaningless initials that have nothing to do with the game or anything else in the known universe. And he created TSR. And TSR looked at the game and said, we can make a hell of a lot of money out of it. And so there was Dungeons and Dragons, a registered trademark of TSR Incorporated.
Ooh, 16.
wisdom.
Never mind, I thought it was a good idea. I was only trying to help.
All right. You're all going on a quest for What was your first thing you
heard? Well, you know, I'm always the first.
All of the back.
Observe again!
walking down the hall towards you.
Is this person a head or a woman?
A woman.
Is it Larry Elmore woman?
Lady, who do you call a maid?
You're not dead.
Our cleric is the one of resurrection.
I do?
It's on kind of a 9-month schedule.
buying paperback as opposed to hardback. The paperbacks, the way the schedule is currently set up, the paperbacks are going to be released at the same time as the following hardback. So the paperback on Devin, for example, will be out in the next couple months, along with the hardback in the second. The third book is finished.
Yeah,
it's away. And we were going to work on the outline of the fourth book here, but we've had so much fun that so we just haven't gotten around to doing it.
Any more questions?
We are running a seminar tomorrow morning at 8 o'clock. on Death Gate and what's in store.
Half of which we can't tell you.
I might be coerced to Margaret Weis has on that program.
Well, we might. Sing. Hey, yeah. Yeah.
Is there any other questions?
Yes, well, not really. Well, he was going to sing the Knights of Salami, right?
Yeah. 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 Well, it that Mike and walked into it, and he immediately came out with, Dragonlance, I should beat his underpants. I decided one day that the nicest salami in Houston. Now you have to help me, okay? This song cannot be sung normally, so, and you'll understand why. Yes, you have to. Yes. Like a good idea when I rub it in. Okay. There you are. Thank you. Let's try again. I would teach you the bum ba dum ba dum, but I don't think you're ready for that. Okay, here we go. There you are. In a depth of a dungeon. Okay. Staring in the dark. In the eyes of a dragon.
Involves the fact that we left PSR and then we went back to PSR and supposed to do product for them, and then
left again. We consider ourselves quite smarter. it's all very complicated. I'd like to love the Rose and Crown series very much.
Yeah.
We were gone from, we had left PSR as I think we were finishing, I think we were finishing the third Legends rooftop. Shortly after that. We left PSR at that point. And then we went out and explored some other avenues and got in with bands and books.
So
we'll treat this very nicely. And that must tell you something if you mention that. then we returned to PSR. PSR asked us to come back, actually. Offered us a kind of unique position.
TSR kind of managed to end up with Dark Sword too?
No.
Just
no, Dark Sword is ours. I've got hopes of doing another trilogy on Dark Sword. Or at least another book.
The crash.
Tipkin is not dead.
No, Tipkin is not dead. Just sleeping. And so we would like to do that. I'd like to do another road book. And Deathgate keeps us extremely occupied. And Margaret's writing her series, and I'm writing my series. And we're doing our best to become the first reader reactor writing team. Anything else?
Where would you say your ideas come from? Do you do a lot of read other fantasy authors, your imagination, and your life experience? Where do your ideas come from?
Everywhere. Ideas, to a great extent, are our business. This kind of, I guess, where our expertise lies, or our work, is having ideas. We both read whenever possible. We aren't writing. I've been reading, primarily right now, I've been reading biographies. I've been reading Marco Polo, biography of Marco Polo, and Galileo. Just anything and everything that I can find to read. Where do you get it?
How about Detroit.
Anything else? Yes.
So which of the major Dragonlance characters came first?
The chicken or the egg? Actually, the evolution of the Dragonlance characters, as far as we are concerned, the original characters were born in committee. At least the way I feel about it, their flesh and blood was born in committee. A bunch of guys got together and we pondered what kinds of things should be in this Dragonlance thing that I had in mind to do. And we said, oh, well, we ought to have a fire. That'd be neat. The second trilogy, yo, fine. The first trilogy, no. I know. Although there were times when things got a little bit out of hand. Lord Soth, for example. We had a big problem with Lord Soth. We wanted the bad guy in this module that I was working on at the time. And and I was kind of playing around and trying different things, and then all of a sudden, Lord Soft sprang into being in my mind. And it was an incredibly powerful experience. He was so big, so bad.
How bad was he?
I instantly knew his entire history. I instantly knew where he had come from, how he had gotten this way. And I jumped up out of my cubicle over to our working time, and I ran over to Margaret and said, "Margaret, I got to tell you about this guy. He was incredible." Lord Soft actually has become so powerful in the course of the series that we had to kind of keep an eye on him every
time. Yeah, he was very so charismatic, he kept kind of wanting to take over the book. And so we had to keep reminding him that he was only a minor character.
And I don't.
But that's all right, kids are currently taking him to write the We're going to put Lord Soft and write the law. Too late, he's already there.
Why? Hey, he'll be in and people will buy it and, you know, yeah. It's like special guest star.
Tracy always said that the second hardest thing to do would be to get Dragonlance started, and the first hardest thing to do would be to stop it. And that turned out to be the case.
I personally feel very badly that I wasn't able to do that for you. And I know that that sounds wrong. But so often we see in fantasy, we see people who write the never-ending series of books. You know, it gets to the point where you seem to feel like, oh, I've got a house payment coming due, let's do it. And the plots wander on and on and on. Dragonlance, there were two stories of Dragonlance. There was the chronicle story, which was the epic fantasy, high fantasy story. And then there was the twin story, the story we really wanted to tell, grew out of the first one, knew it needed to be told. There were many, many other stories. Many, many other stories. And later, we included a lot of those stories in the tales. But really, even though those stories were very good and should have been told, I personally would have preferred that it had ended. That we would have been left with this beautiful experience that we have shared. That we would have been left with this beautiful experience that we have shared and could keep it as a special thing and take it off the shelf now and then and feel very warmly about it. As it is, it goes on and on and on, exploring and doing things that Dragonlance was never intended to do, going in directions that Dragonlance, as far as I was concerned, was never intended to go. So I feel very badly that that is the case. You would have better been served. Definitely special day. We have a final offering for you tonight. Something that something very special.
Thank you. clearly the deadly spell is cast in that dread place will prevent anyone from winning its way through to the tower.
Yamamar, where are you?
Caution, fool. She betrayed her brother. She betrayed you. Not trust her.
Yamamar! I made it to the grove. Barely. I've come to help you stop Richland. Help me, Yamamar.
These days are rough, in the dark, and waiting in regret. waded past all decision, past the heart and shadows to tell you this. And absences grew more beautiful, more poisonous. You're an adder of the orchids in the swimming night, where passion, like a shark drawn down a bloodstream, murders four senses, only taste. Buckling into itself, binding the blood of song, shark unravels the belly tatters in the long throat's tunnel. And knowing this, the night still seems such a rich sun. Crosses of desires, you know. I'd still be part of these alones. To my arms I would take in the darkness, blessed, remain my pleasure. But the light, Gideon, the light, and the sun spangles the rain-gorged sidewalks, and the oil from doused lamps rises in the sun-struck water, splintering into rainbows. I arise, and though the storm resettles on the city, I think of Stern and Lorana and the others, but Stern the foremost, who could see the sun straight through the fog and cloudland. How could I abandon these? So, into the shadow, and not your shadow. Eager greatness expecting love. I ride the storm.
You are right, you belong to darkness, to death.
along.
Get out of my way!
You cannot leave this place.
I'll go through you.
Wrong.
Set aside very light, a candle torch and rotting wood, and listen to the turn of night caught in your rising blood. How quiet is the midnight, love. How warm the winds where ravens fly, where all the changing moonlight, love, fades in your fading eye. How loud your heart is calling, love, how close the darkness at your breast. How hectic are the rivers, love, drawn through your dying wrist. And love, what heat your frail skin hides, as pure as salt, as sweet as death. And in the dark, the red moon rides, the foxfire of your breath. Yeah. Bill what? Like it.